हेलो गाइस एंड वेलकम टू अफिशनाडोज डेन वेयर वी स्टे इन क्लास। गाइस आज बात करते हैं द ग्लेनलिवेट की। तो कभी आप लोगों ने ये चीज़ सोची है कि जब बाकी विस्कीज का नाम ग्लेनफिडिक या फिर ग्लेनमोरेंजी या फिर एबलुअ या फिर मैकेलन है तो फिर सिर्फ ग्लेनलिवेट के आगे दी क्यों लगता है? कभी सोचा है कि दी ग्लेनलिवेट क्यों है? Well, I'll let you know a very interesting story today about the Glenlivet. The year was 1822. King George IV came to Speyside asking for specifically Glenlivet dram. Okay, the reason why this is very important is because us time pe there were illegal distilleries running in Scotland, operational in Scotland. So, the reason why King George IV came and asked for Glenlivet is very important because Glenlivet at that point of time was so important a dram, a whiskey, a name ki King George IV bhi aake by name usko maang rahe the. Then came the year 1823 when Alexander Gordon, the Duke of Gordon at that point in time, gave an idea to the Parliament to roll out the Excise Act. अब एक्साइज एक्ट में क्या था कि लोग लाइसेंस वगैरह अप्लाई करेंगे, उनको डिस्टिलरीज को लाइसेंस मिल जाएगा, दे वुड एक्ट एज अ लीगल डिस्टिलरी एंड एवरीथिंग वुड बी सॉर्टेड। बट इसके पीछे मकसद ये था अलेक्जेंडर गॉर्डन का कि वो खुद ही अपने बैकयार्ड में इलीगल डिस्टिलरी का पॉट स्टिल लगा के बैठे हुए थे, सो ही वॉन्टेड टू मेक दैट लीगल एज वेल। गोइंग फॉरवर्ड इन द ईयर 1824, ग्लेनलिवेट अप्लाइड फॉर अ लाइसेंस एंड इट बिकेम among the first distilleries to apply for a license, and they obtained it as well. So George Smith was the owner of Glenlivet at that point of time, and he established and opened the distillery in the year 1824, and he started freely doing business. Now this actually made people jealous jo ki unse bahut purani distilleries operate kar rahe the magar wo abhi bhi illegal thi. So yes, because Glenlivet was famous, he was getting threats as well. So what other distilleries used to do was apply the name Glenlivet with their whiskey name, and of course people would get confused that this is a Glenlivet whiskey and they would buy it. So Glenlivet was not happy with this. Eventually उन्होंने business ऐसे ही किया किसी तरीके से till the year 1871 when unfortunately he passed away and the distillery was passed on to his son John Gordon Smith. अब in the year 1871 when the distillery was passed over to him, he was not happy with people using the word Glenlivet and spoiling the image of his distillery. So in the year 1876 he applied and requested the government to exclusively give him the access to the word Glenlivet and no one else can use it. And eventually he got it, but still people were confused with the word Glenlivet. So he devised this plan to add the before Glenlivet, and hence the Glenlivet came into picture, and till date they use the Glenlivet as their brand. So that is all about the Glenlivet. Please go ahead, enjoy your dram and stay classy and cheers.